All right, story time. Meet Sam, a new dev at Acme Corp. And she's pumped to build some new features. But instead, she's knee-deep in 12 different repos, in looking through 3 wikis, in trying to understand a Helm chart and 2 bash scripts, one of which is named Do Not Touch. That means that 3 weeks later, she's actually shipped nothing. She has 0 commits, and she's very frustrated. It's a bad onboarding experience until she meets Maya, an infrastructure engineer who's tired of playing ticket Jenga. So she has a fix. She's going to build an internal developer platform. So Maya audits the chaos of Acme Corp, and she spots a pattern. Dozens of services contain just copied boilerplate code for builds and for infrastructure, etc. She distills all this repeated code into 3 components, and she wraps those inside a template, and she sets up a way to provision them. Now you can pick a template, drop in your details, and boom, you get a repo, you get a pipeline, you get infrastructure, you get secrets. It's all provisioned automatically. That means Sam can now spend minutes choosing a template instead of days digging through all these files. These templates, right, they become the backbone of Acme's platform. Maya also builds a web portal, and in it, you can see the services and under them, the owners and dashboards and docs, and it's all in one place. Sam doesn't need to ask questions about who goes where. She doesn't need to talk to ops, no ticket ping pong. She just picks a template, picks a service, and she goes. Each component comes with baked-in security and observability and cost defaults. Sam doesn't need to think about compliance. The platform thinks for her. The security defaults are built in. Everything that Sam launches shows up in the service dashboard, and so others know what's going on. Onboarding drops from 3 weeks to 2 days. Services ship faster, fewer bugs in production, and when a critical vulnerability hits, the platform helps them patch everything in hours, not weeks. These wins aren't random, right? These are the advantages of an internal developer platform. In IDP, you get standardization, which means you get consistent builds and reliable services. With an IDP, you get centralization, so costs and ownership and config are all in one place. With an IDP, you get self-service, so devs can get what they need done, right? And with an IDP, you also get guardrails. So all this velocity doesn't sacrifice security, doesn't sacrifice reliability. And you don't need to build all of this at once. You can start with one pain point, one source of friction, whether it's provisioning or secrets or pipelines, standardize that, right? Deliver that one golden use case. Get buy-in. Over time, this platform will become the default way to build, and you'll keep building on it. That's why, 6 months later, Sam ships features in days, not weeks. And Maya sleeps through the night. She doesn't have a big backlog of tickets, of things to provision. Acme invested in a better developer experience, one that scales. Now, if you're ready to do the same, check out this next video on platform engineering, which is also awesome, I promise.